I'd lived in Edmonton for a number of years, and I was connected to the Banff Centre through the Banff Television Festival. I knew when it started. I was an emerging filmmaker at the time, and we all wrote letters to encourage the government to support this festival. So I started going to the Banff Television Festival, I'd say, since the late 70s. So I got to know everybody who was interested with that establishment. Well, I was working in Alberta at the time. I was doing my own individual productions as an independent filmmaker, and I think I might have had a full-time job also. But somebody approached me and said they were doing this film about the Cuban artists who were participating in Afrocubanismo, and would I be interested in being a co-producer? So I was contacted by whoever was acting on that. I believe it was Raymond Gravel was the person who contacted me. And I was interested in the topic. So the minute he approached me, I didn't hesitate. So I came on board because I was really fascinated by this idea of Cuban culture. You know, I grew up in Trinidad. And we are not too far from, well, we are relatively far from Cuba. But the whole Latino culture was something that was very, common in Trinidad. Trinidad, by its very name, is Spanish. And so the Spanish culture remained in Trinidad, even though we were an English-speaking country by that time. But when we listen to the music on the radio stations, there's a lot of music coming from Venezuela. So there was an immediate connection for me on the Latino rhythm. The other thing that fascinated me, I took a presentation on the history of film in Cuba, which was one of the topics covered by ICAIC at part of the festival in Banff. And that opened my eyes because they presented documentaries on Santeria, and I got immediately excited because we have the same thing in Trinidad, except we refer to it as Shango. So that was my connection there. The drumming was the same, the dance movements were the same, and you know. So I felt as though I knew that part of the culture, even though I didn't speak the language. And I remember one time as a very, very young man, the first time I saw an Agra reporter, an Agra recorder, was some people from the United States. They came and they went to this, you know, what we'd call in the countryside, and they were just recording people doing the Shango dance. And I realized that there was some sort of anthropological significance to what they were doing, but we were not allowed to participate in the Shango. However, cultural groups existed, and some of the older people would come out and do these dances. So even though it wasn't official, it was ingrained in your system. So you'd hear the beats and automatically you know what the dances were. So when I went to Banff, or when I saw these films and I saw the Cubans participating in Santeria, I could have joined in the dance expression there, even though I didn't grow up in Cuba. So that is what fascinated me, and that is what pulled me into this Afro-Cubanismo. I mean, everything that was in the film was interesting, and I thought it would be an eye-opener to Western people. Certainly it was an eye-opener to me to just see the visual similarity between the culture of Cuba and the culture of Trinidad.